Who makes this video? You probably guessed Red Bull, and you would be right. You might have noticed the branding on the athlete's attire, or maybe it just seemed like a Red Bull video. In recent years, extreme sports footage paired with catchy music and high production values has become a Red Bull signature, and nobody does it better. Of course, Rebel wasn't always the content giant that we know today. Devised in 1975 by TC Pharmaceutical, Crate and Dang was the drink that would be released to the Thai public in 1976. Originally intended as a beverage for Thai laborers, the drink had a working class image that was only bolstered by them sponsoring Thai boxing matches, which sported the logo of two Red Bulls charging each other. In 1982, Dietrich Matchevich traveled to Thailand and met Chalio, owner of TC Pharmaceutical. During his visit, Matchevich discovered that Crate and Dang helped cure his jet lag. In 1984, Matchevich co-founded Red Bull with Uvidia and turned it into an international brand. Each partner invested $500,000 of savings to found the company and held an equal stake. As Red Bull branched out internationally, it frequently used humor to sell its products. Here's one of the more outlandish Rebel Gives You Wings clips.
Red Bull Gives You Wings.
That clip was from the early 2000s, and Red Bull is not the same company it was then. Red Bull can be thought of as an energy drink company, but really, they are content creation companies. Red Bull has mastered the art of creating a spectacle. I'm sure you all remember Red Bull Stratos, when Australian skydiver Felix Baumgartner leaped from the edge of space, as was widely touted on media. The total jump from leaving the capsule to landing on the ground lasts approximately 10 minutes and reached a staggering 8 million live viewers on YouTube. Unlike the original Crate and Dang, which was popular with blue-collar workers in Thailand, Red Bull's relaunch repositioned the drink as a trendy, upscale beverage. First introduced at Austrian ski resorts, pricing was a key differentiator, with Red Bull positioned as a premium beverage and Crate and Dang as a lower-cost item. Red Bull's target demographic would become individuals who can benefit from the tangible properties of a can of Red Bull, meaning those involved in the extreme sports communities or other niche interest groups. While Red Bull's energy drink product is solid in and of itself, it's the company's marketing that truly sets them apart. Amazingly, Red Bull has aligned their entire company with their brand vision. From the very extreme to the very niche, Red Bull sponsors everything and has fostered community engagement and respect on a level unheard of in marketing. Any niche sport you can think of, they are willing to sponsor. From snowmobile jumping,
it's only
to chess?
You don't have a chance against me. I can calculate 90 trillion moves in advance. Not fair. Not fair.
And of course, Red Bull leads the way on the new frontier that is investment in esports.
He sharked under him and got the up air. It was incredible.
Red Bull excels at authentic consumer engagement. How do you connect with the hyper-connected? Red Bull's sense of profiling and connecting with niche communities and their knack for connecting their product with the millennial demographic didn't start with Felix Baumgartner's free fall from the edge of space. Red Bull has realized that they need to put their product in real, emotional spaces. This strategy has allowed Red Bull to make a name for itself by supporting athletes that exist on the fringes of pop culture. Red Bull has been involved with professional video game players since 2006. Red Bull understands that to connect with consumers, particularly millennials, needs to provide context-rich experiences, and they are masters of doing just that. The total esports market is now worth over $1 billion. With a market value that high, other companies are sure to want a piece of the esports pie. What can they learn from Red Bull? Realize that marketing to millennials in 2018 is no easy task. It's not a TV ad or a magazine spread. It takes a multifaceted, context-based, content approach with a focus on authenticity and community building. In addition to sponsoring a dizzying amount of players and esports organizations, Red Bull has put on their own esport tournaments. With names like Red Bull Battlegrounds and Red Bull Clash Course, the events always aim to put on an entertaining show featuring some of the best video game players in their genre. You may have seen this movie before, but did you know that it's made by Red Bull? In addition to being the leading energy drink company in the world, Red Bull has expanded their brand and created three sister companies under the Red Bull brand, all with their own revenue streams. Scenes you're watching, you're probably caught on Netflix, as they are from the snowboarding movie Art of Flight, produced by Red Bull's media company, Red Bull Media House. This sister company has released an amazing 12 full-length feature films, and some of them don't even feature sports. The other two companies are redbull.tv and the Red Bulletin. Red Bull TV streams live sports events from all over the world, and they even charge television networks for the right to broadcast their footage. However, you can see any of their content for free on redbull.tv. The Red Bulletin is a sporting magazine available in print that has everything you would expect, from amazing photos and innovative content to fantastic interviews with Red Bull athletes. These interviews and interest stories only further help to promote Red Bull's community engagement philosophy. And if you think Red Bull products stop there, you'd be wrong. They have all their physical products like t-shirts, hats, and other attire. They have other print media such as the Terra Matter magazine. They have a radio station, RBMA Radio. They have a music label with Red Bull Music Publishing and Red Bull Records, all under the Red Bull umbrella. They even have created their own game, such as the Red Bull Reality Check game, Gran Turismo 6, as produced by Red Bull, and Red Bull Air Race, the game. Don't you wanna know me? Be a friend of mine. I'll share some wisdom with you. Don't you ever get lonely from time to time. Don't let the system get you down. The main drift across the seas and the oceans. A permanent itinerant is what I've chosen. I find myself in a big city prison, arisen from the vision of mankind. How do you give recommendations to a company that's consistently used as an example of doing everything right? Not easily. As such, our recommendations revolve around the esports world, and ways to become even more pervasive in the community. While Red Bull is a master of the big spectacle, they could improve their smaller scale weekday content in two ways. First, hire a community member to represent Red Bull in whatever corner of the internet the most niche video game and sports communities lie. Have them simply casually use the forum and talk to other members, making sure not to come across as an advertisement, but rather as a way to become more involved. Just being there will keep Red Bull in the community's mind's eye and may even gain some useful insights from their time there. The second is to create more weekday content by sponsoring small video game and sports tournaments. Everyone knows what to watch on the weekend, but there is tremendous demand for more weekday content, especially on streaming sites like Twitch TV. Just having a Red Bull fridge at every venue possible reminds communities that Red Bull is there to support them. With just a few small investments, you might see a Red Bull fridge at all minor events, and the next time people in that community crave an energy drink, they might just crack a Red Bull.